Robert here, and welcome to episode 7 of season 5 of RobGioMegacollabs. For this episode, we're going to be ranking The Weeknd's 4th album, After Hours. So After Hours is an album where Abel decides to allow it to contrast stylistically with his previous album Starboy, but music journalists have also noted that this feels more like an artistic reinvention for him, incorporating more new wave and dream pop influences. However, to say that this was a step up to Starboy, which was already a great album, would be a strong understatement. This is arguably his strongest release to date, and I cannot wait to see your rankings. So 7 people have joined this episode, and those people are the YouTube Studios Fan 2022, Dark Strawberry, Raymond Garza, Te Logo CDC, and Roblox Fanatic 2K6, DJ Cams, Searman, Helios Cheetos, and Miguel Sanchez. So yeah, great roster of people here with us today. Special shout out to Raymond Garza for joining this series as a newcomer. I know he has appeared on the Logo History Collab many, many times, but never have I seen him appear on this series before, so warm welcome to Raymond Garza, everyone. And yeah, let's get the disclaimers out of the way. Before we get started, please keep in mind that these rankings are based on our personal enjoyment and nostalgia and are also based on our personal opinions as well, so our rankings might be different from yours. If you would like to let me know how you would rank the album, or just like to let me know what your opinion on this album may be, just feel free to leave that down in the comment section down below. And yeah, I have no other fancy talk left me to say now. Without any further ado, it's After Hours, ranked from worst to best as ranked by more than one person. Enjoy.
Number 14, repeat after me. Number 13, scared to live. Number 12, Until I Bleed Out. Number 11, Too Late. The first song tied for the number 9 spot is Alone Again. The second song tied for the number 9 spot is Faith. The first song tied for the number 7 spot is Snow Child. If I didn't make it, then I'd probably make my wrist bleed. Not to mislead, turn my nightmares into big dreams. Whole squad mobbing, even though we only 6 deep. I was singing notes while my niggas. The second song tied for the number 7 spot is Escape from LA. They think your kindness is so weak. No, you don't give it up so easy, baby. But you just wanna have my attention. Number 6, Heartless. Heartless, and I'm back to my ways cause I'm heartless. All this money and this pain got me heartless. For life cause I'm heartless. Said I'm heartless, trying to be. Number 5, Hardest to Love. And I can see it, I can see it. Number 4, In Your Eyes. See, there's something burning inside you. Oh, inside you. In your eyes. I know it hurts to smile, but you try. Number 3, After Hours. Number 2, Blinding Lights. I'm blinded by the lights. No, I can't sleep until I feel your touch. I say, ooh, I'm drowning in. And finally, number 1, Save Your Tears.
proper. And yeah, thank you to everyone who's participated in the Spec Club ranking. It is always greatly appreciated. And now it's time for me to say what I think about After Hours. And yeah, again, this is pretty much his strongest and just overall arguably his best album to date. To me, the lyrics on here are also really strong as well, and this album has excellent world building and atmospherics from a production standpoint. On top of that, the album spawned hits that scored big time, such as Blinding Lights and Deservingly So. Just I love the shit out of Blinding Lights, and same thing with Savior Tears. That one deserved to get a hit. I love Save Your Tears. And then the other tracks that didn't get as much attention as those two tracks, like In Your Eyes and Hardest to Love and Heartless. Man, these three tracks are also some serious highlights. The only track that I wasn't really feeling on here was Snow Child. I thought it sounded okay. But like, literally the rest is at least good stuff. Every track, like almost every track, is just at least good to great stuff, and it's just overall his best album to date. And if you somehow haven't gotten the chance to listen to this amazing album yet, please do so as you wish. And yeah, this is also one of my favorite albums from 2020 as well. So yeah, let's see what some of you had to say. Former to let me know what your opinion on the album is. If you do fill out that section, then your opinion will be in the next episode segment. Please note that one last section is also completely optional, so you really don't have to fill out that one last section, but filling it out is always greatly appreciated.
Also, I give the participants an option to rate this album a score out of 10, and as a result, the average rating for this album is an 8.9 out of 10.
So yeah, that's gonna do it for season 5, episode 7 of RobGioMegacollabs. The next episode will be the season 5 finale, and it will be on The Weeknd's 5th and most recent album, Dawn FM. The link to the form for Dawn FM will be in the description down below and also in the pinned comment as per usual. And the form will be closing on Sunday, July 3rd, 2022 at 5 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. So yeah, I'm pretty much looking forward to seeing how many people submit to this. Because, like, even though Dawn FM doesn't necessarily beat After Hours as my favorite album from him, it comes very close. It's just as much of a wild rollercoaster ride as After Hours was. And on top of that, it already secured a spot on my personal list of my top 50 favorite albums of the year so far. So if you happen to witness the release of the second annual 50 Fantastic Albums of the Year of Extravaganza, be sure to expect Dawn FM to appear on that list, because Dawn FM is just amazing. So, yeah, submit if you're interested. So, yeah, we've made it to the end of this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a like, share this one with your friends if you want to, and leave a comment down below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe as we're on the road to 7,000 subscribers. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye, guys.